Just wait for a few people to come in. I think the bell ringers are always the latecomers. So yeah, good morning. I'm Jane. Welcome to all in church and those that are joining us online. And a special welcome to those that are going to be baptized this morning, to Lula and her family, and to Penny and Dee. And warm welcome to their friends and family that are supporting them. It's great that you're with us, and we pray that it will be a special time for you this morning. So everything you need will be displayed on the screen during the service, and after the baptism, the children will be leaving for their own groups in the hall, and then they'll rejoin us towards the end of the service. We will be serving refreshments after the service. You'd be very welcome to stay for that. If you need any facilities, we've got a toilet through that door there, or back through the link, the entrance that you came in. So when you came in, you probably had one of these. We call it the bulletin. So it's useful for the useful information on the front for any visitors, and it also highlights what we've got going on. So there's lots of events, dates going on. They feature a lot around food and drink, surprisingly, and suitable for all ages. So do have a look to see what's coming up. I'd just like to highlight a few things that are coming up this week. Tonight we've got a service here at 6:30, and also a service on Thursday evening at 7:30 for Ascension. And then secondly, Thy Kingdom Come is a global prayer movement that happens between Ascension and Pentecost. And St. Mary's is having a prayer day as part of that. So please do sign up on the, there's a sheet at the back to sign up to take part in that on the Wednesday, the 24th of May. And I think there was also a link in an email that you might have received from Natasha. And then lastly, on Saturday, next weekend, we're hosting the Kids Club Crafternoon Tea. So everyone's welcome to that with children. But we'd also love some help. So there's another sign-up sheet at the back if you can help with that as well. So this morning, you might be reminded about your own baptism and the start of your journey with Jesus. We may not remember our baptism. I think I was 5 or 6 months old, so a little bit older than Tallulah when I was baptized. But it is a significant start for our journey of faith, becoming part of God's family, where we are all children of the same Heavenly Father and sisters and brothers together. So if you can just put up the greeting. So with King Charles's coronation, probably still fresh in your memories, I can't believe it's only a week ago now, but these are the words that one of the choristers spoke to open the coronation service. And I know we said them last Sunday too, but I just thought as we say them together this morning at our time of worship, we can acknowledge that Jesus is here in our presence. He's why we're here, and he's delighted that we're here. So let's say together our opening greeting. Your Majesty, as children of the Kingdom of God, we welcome you in the name of King of Kings. And let's say together this prayer as we confess to God the times when we've been selfish in our thoughts and actions, knowing he loves us unconditionally. So again, we say together, loving God, in Jesus you offer life to the world and love to its people. When we see life only for ourselves, forgive us. Help us to hear your transforming love, speaking to us of respect, dignity and worth, telling us that we are loved and that we are to love one another. Amen. In the knowledge of this love, work through us to bring your justice to the world. in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now Stephen and Fiona and Janet are going to lead us in a couple of songs of worship, so please stand.
Thanks, Jane.
Begin.
How great is our God? And it's because he's great, because he is wonderful, that we come and we invite people to baptism. So please, did you take your seats? And with the baptism parties, so parents and godparents, come to the front, please.
Our King, Majesty, and in the words of this song, it says, he is exalted, the King, with a capital K. The King is exalted on high, and I will praise him. It actually was written a long time ago, in the last, technically the last century, actually. It is a long time ago, but it is actually a lovely song. So it might not be familiar to one or two of you, and one or two of you will think, I knew this all along. Join in if you know it already, of course. You'll pick it up quickly, I'm sure, as well. If you're able to stand and let's sing, He is Exalted.
Please take your seats as Neil will come and bring the reading from the Bible now.
The first reading today is from Luke 3, verses 21 to 22. When all the people were being baptized, Jesus was baptized too. And as he was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you, I am well pleased." The second reading is from John chapter 14, verses 15 to 22. Jesus promises the Holy Spirit. "If you love me, you will obey what I command, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever. The Spirit of truth. The world cannot accept him because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Before long, the world will not see me anymore, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I am in you. Whoever has my commands and obeys them, he is the one who loves me. He who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I too will love him and show myself to him. Then Judas, not Judas Iscariot, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks, Neil. Let's pray. Loving God, I pray that we might hear you, that things that are relevant will fit for us today. Amen. Well, it's lovely to have everyone here, and particularly to have Tallulah's family here and Penny and Dee. I know for Penny and Dee that it's been a long wait, having had a whole load of sickness and stuff in February when they were meant to be being baptized then. So it's lovely to have you here. Thinking today about kingship and what that means, or what it means to have a king, and what it means for Jesus to be our king. I expect that lots of you have got one of these little red things, and some of you, your red one will be changing or has changed to a black one or a different one because we're out of the EU. Mine says, Her Britannic Majesty's Secretary of State requests and requires in the name of Her Majesty all those whom it may concern to allow the bearer to pass freely without let or hindrance and to afford the bearer such assistance and protection as may be necessary. How many of you have read that in your passport? A few at the back. Okay. Our passport gives us entry to places. But it's about that authority that has been delegated by the Queen, now the King's Secretary of State. Our King, our Queen work for the good of all. They're there to serve us, to help us, although we've not always seen that. In the UK, our king delegates his authority to the police, to the courts, to Parliament, which is a big change from the kingship of a couple of hundred years ago, where if we weren't following the particular way that that king wanted us to go, we could find ourselves in prison or on death row or killed. In other places around the world, we know that not following the king or whichever particular person who is in control means that you are likely to get killed in other ways. But in the democracy that we have, we know the way the king and the line of succession goes. It's not a surprise that Charles has come and in the Queen's place. It's not a surprise to us that William will be next in line and then George. And the Jews had been waiting a long time for their king to come, for the Messiah, the one who was going to rule and was going to reign and who was going to bring God's way, God's kingship. They'd been waiting for a long time. but they weren't aware of when the signs were being fulfilled. One of the early ones was the reading that we had that Neil read to us, that when Jesus was baptized by John in the desert, a baptism of repentance, the Holy Spirit came as an affirmation from God the Father. "This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased." The Holy Spirit was there revealing the truth to those who would see and notice. But with everything else that was going on around, it was very easy to miss. Those who follow Christ, those who choose to follow him, have Jesus as our King. We have the King of Kings in our lives, and we are inheritors of a different kingdom. It's a kingdom for us where God's ways are foremost, where God's ways are what we're working for. And as you brought Tallulah and Penny, and as Dee has come for baptism, what you're saying is, yes, we're coming to have Christ in our lives. You've been saying yes to following him, yes to helping Tallulah and Penny know God's goodness, yes to helping them follow him. And I hope that as you're doing that, you know that it's because God has immensely good things for them, that he has an abundance of life for them, that he came because he loved them. God so loved the world. God so loved Dee, he so loved Penny, he so loved Tallulah, he so loved each of us, that he sent his Son, that whoever believes will not perish, but have eternal life. Life that changes us here now, in this world, in this life, but is life and promises life but when we die. And Jesus' kingdom is different from the ways of the world. It's not a kingdom that comes by force. It's a kingdom that comes with love. And so Jesus speaks at the Passover meal at the Last Supper, the words that we heard just now. He speaks to his friends, to his disciples, to those who've been walking with him. He's told them, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." He's told them, "Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father." He's pointing them to say, look and see what the good things are that are coming of the kingdom, God's kingdom that is coming among you. Look and notice. Don't assume this is for granted. These miracles aren't what you have expected. They're not what you've seen before, are they? Don't take them for granted. Look and notice and know. The kingdom of God brings good things. The disciples have been involved. They've seen these things happen. When they went and did what Jesus told them to do, they saw lives transformed. They saw people healed. God's kingdom in Jesus was breaking in and transforming lives in a very different way from the wars that we see around the world today. Putin does not try and take Ukraine with love. He comes with force, with bombs, with fighting. And we have choices in this world about the kings that we follow. We are subjects, I expect most of us, of Charles. We try, most of us, most of the time, to keep the law. There are things that we defend. We defend our homes. I know from the floods that there were earlier in the week of people in this congregation who were there pulling up the grate to make sure that the water could flow away to defend homes. We don't expect King Charles to come and help us with those sorts of things. But Jesus promises that the Holy Spirit will come and help us. If you love me, follow my commandments, Jesus says. And those commandments are to love God with all your heart, to love your neighbor as yourself. They're all summed up with that, but Jesus also told them, love your neighbor, love your enemies, forgive those who hurt you, turn your cheek to the one who would smite you, show generosity, follow what you've seen Jesus doing. There's a whole list of things to do. And they're not the sorts of things that we would do on our own, of our own volition. Why would we love our enemies? Why would we forgive those who have hurt us? Why would we show generosity to people that we don't know? Because Jesus says they are good things to do. Because Jesus says that by doing them, you will have life. But he says we need his help. And he says, if you do these things, I will ask the Father, and he will give you the advocate, the counselor, the encourager, the one who strengthens, the Holy Spirit, who will never leave you. The Holy Spirit leads us into all truth. He helps us, he opens us to see what's good and what is of God. King Charles can't come and give each one of us what we need. And actually, we probably wouldn't want him to be around all the time, would we? But the Holy Spirit comes to help us because he loves us. He comes to ensure and to help see the kingship of Christ grow. He can be, in a way, a bit like a divine sat-nav who prompts us with our understanding of the instruction manual, the Bible, who calls us to listen to the still small voice, who reveals more of the Father's love, who shows us the landscape, not just the direction that you see on the sat-nav. Those who follow Christ, knowing the Spirit, become more aware of the Spirit for us. And I'd encourage you as parents, godparents, but for all of us, if you don't know, ask God to reveal the Spirit to you or to point out more of the things that the Spirit wants to show you. The Spirit brings colour into our lives in places where we didn't realise that we were colourblind. The Spirit shows us things that we wouldn't have seen otherwise. If you're a bird watcher, you need to see the birds, whereas others of us, I see a bird making a noise, so what? The Spirit points those things out to reveal what they are. The Spirit comes and brings a sensitivity to us, to the things of God. Jesus says, in the world, those around won't see me, but you will. Those who follow Christ and his kingship will see and know the things of God that we couldn't imagine. Those who love me, follow my commandments. And because they love me, the Father will love them and I will love them. The Spirit reveals the Father's heart to us. Because we love God, because they love me, the Father will love us. It's like if you've got children and they've got friends, You invite their friends back to your house, don't you? Because they are friends. You know that they've got relationship. It's the same with God the Father, that when he knows that we love Jesus, he says, "Welcome into my home." Jesus is not out to catch us out. He gives us the Spirit to help us to keep on following. He gives us the Spirit to help us grow in the things of the kingdom. And he wants us to grow and know more. Just as you, as parents, want good things for your children, God wants good things for us. And the King of Kings leads us into things we could not imagine. He is by our side. He is with us by the Spirit. And so today, I wonder what more of the Spirit, what more of God's goodness you would like him to reveal to you. What more you would like to know of his kingship, knowing that it's not a kingship of power, but a kingship of love that gives you access to so much more. He does not give us a physical passport, but he gives us that inner passport of love, guaranteeing the place with Christ for us. Let's pray. Loving God, thank you that you are the King of Kings. And we ask that you would bring more of your Spirit into our lives. The Spirit that draws us to the truth. The Spirit that opens our hearts and minds to God's love. The Spirit that changes and transforms us because we are loved. Holy Spirit, would you do your work amongst us? Grow your love and your truth within us. And help us wherever we are in our journeys of faith to discover more of your goodness and your love. Amen. Please do stand. Thank you.
Sweetest of loves, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone in your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, to be overcome by your presence.
go back to the beginning. There is nothing worth more.
There is nothing worth more than we'll ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves. When my heart becomes free, my shame is undone in your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. Experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Please sit, and as we're in the presence of the Lord, we spend some time in prayer with him. So Anne's going to lead us in our prayers.
At the end of each prayer, I will say, Lord, in your love, and if you could respond, hear our prayer, that would be lovely. So in the presence of our loving, almighty God, let us pray. Lord Jesus, we cannot thank you enough for your amazing love for each one of us, whatever we think of ourselves. Your love is so strong and deep. In comparison, our love for you is so weak and superficial. Oh, come, Holy Spirit, and fan the dull embers of our love for you. Come and fill each one of us to overflowing, we pray. Show us yourself and what you are doing in and around us. Grow your truth and love in each one of us. Lord, we pray this particularly for Dee, Penny and Tallulah on this day of their baptism, their commitment to you. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank you for Dee, Penny and Tallulah. Thank you for your love for them, And thank you that the children's parents have responded to your loving invitation to follow you. We ask you to continue drawing these families ever closer to you and continue to pour your blessings upon them day by day, guiding them forward into the future you have prepared for them. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, at this time of year, we pray for those youngsters taking their GCSEs and A-levels. We are particularly conscious of the interruptions they have experienced in the last 4 years. Thank you for their teachers and support staff, and we ask your continued enabling and blessings for them. We ask you, Holy Spirit, to grant peace and calmness to the students so that they can do their best, that the results may provide genuine guidance into the next phase of their lives. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. Lord, our youngsters are free to go to school and college. We pray for those in other countries who cannot, especially praying for Sudan, for girls in Afghanistan, for youngsters in conflict zones. We pray for youngsters in disaster zones where earthquakes, wildfires, or whatever have destroyed their homes and schools. We pray that somehow these two may find a purpose for their lives that gives them enjoyment and enables them to make a positive contribution to their communities, their countries. Lord, at whatever stage in our lives, we pray that we may continue to find ways to make contributions to our communities with the enabling of your Holy Spirit, shining your light for lives around us and further afield. Lord, in your love, hear our prayer. And we sum up the prayers of our hearts and minds, spoken and unspoken, using the words that the Lord Jesus taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Joan. Praying together, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
If I could have one of, if Tallulah and Zoe and Dee and Penny and Ross would like to come up, please.
In distress, praise.
him still the same forever, slow to chide and swift to bless. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, glorious in his faithfulness. Father, like he tends and spares us, well our feeble frame he knows, in his hands he gently bears us, rescues us from all our foes. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, widely as his mercy flows. Angels in the height adore him, ye behold him face to face, sun and moon bow down before him, dwellers all in time and space. Praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise with us the God of grace.
Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. And we thank you for these gifts that we return to you and ask for you to help us to use them wisely for your kingdom. Amen. Amen. So we finish with a closing prayer that we'll say together. God of power, may the boldness of your spirit transform us. May the gentleness of your spirit lead us. May the gifts of your spirit equip us to serve and worship you now and always. Amen. I'll just invite Sarah to give us our final blessing.
And now may the blessing of God, the God who is Father, Son and Holy Spirit, fill you with his love, assure you of his goodness, and lead you to walk with him in his kingdom. Amen. Bless you and have a good week. Yeah, just